Hey friends, welcome to the YouTube channel All About Electronics. So in this video, we'll understand what is cache memory in computers and the laptops. So in this video, we'll see what is the importance of this cache memory, what is the typical size of this cache memory, and what are the different levels of cache memory that you find inside the computers. So before we understand this cache memory, let us see different kinds of memory that we see inside our computers. So the first kind of memory that we find inside our computers is the non-volatile kind of memory, like a hard disk drive. So this hard disk drive contains a mechanically rotating fast disks, which is also known as a platters. And if you see any commercially available hard disk drive, the typical rotation speed of this disk is either 5400 or 7200 RPM. So as this hard disk drive contains a mechanically rotating part, so in terms of the speed, they are quite slow. So the typical read or write speed that you get with this hard disk drive is in the range of 80 to 150 megabytes per second. But if you see the clock speed of the CPU, it is in the range of 1 GHz up to the 4 GHz. So even though the processor is capable of accepting the data at much higher speed, but it cannot get the data through this hard disk drive at the same rate. And that is where the second kind of memory comes into the picture, that is a random access memory. Now this random access memory is faster compared to the hard disk drive. So this RAM can provide a data to the CPU at a much faster rate compared to the hard disk drive. But still, it is slower than the clock speed of the CPU. So the typical speed of the RAM is in the range of 400 MHz up to the 800 MHz. Still, it is lower than the clock speed of the CPU. But if you see the newer generation of the RAMs like DDR3 and DDR4, then they can operate at a much faster rate, like 1600 MHz or up to the 2100 MHz. So now if you see the speed of these RAMs, they are comparable to the clock speed of the CPU. So now you may say that these newer versions of RAM can supply data to the CPU at the rate at which they want. But the answer is no. So the modern day processors which we are using are not a single core processor, but they are multi-core processors. So this processor could be either dual core, quad core, or maybe even octa core. So if all the cores are asking for data at the same time, then this RAM cannot be able to deliver the data to all the cores at the same time. And that is where this cache memory comes into the picture. So this cache memory is fastest among the all memories. So now this cache memory is also a random access memory, but it is a special kind of RAM, which is known as a static RAM. So unlike the dynamic RAM, which we find inside the normal RAMs, this static RAM is quite fast. And the typical size of this cache memory is in the range of kilobytes up to the megabytes. So the data which is frequently required by the CPU can be supplied by this cache memory. So generally some instructions and some data which is required by the CPU is stored inside this cache memory. So now let us see the different levels of this cache memory. The first level of cache memory is known as a level 1 cache or a L1 cache. So in this level 1 cache, the tiny amount of memory is integrated inside the CPU itself. And all the cores inside the CPU have their individual level 1 cache. So as this level 1 cache is integrated inside the CPU, so they can operate at the same speed of the CPU. And that is the reason the level 1 cache is fastest among the all caches. Now the typical memory size of this level 1 cache is in the range of 2 kilobytes up to the 64 kilobyte. Now inside this level 1 cache, there are two kind of caches. The one is instruction cache and the second is a data cache. So the instruction cache stores all the instructions which is required by the CPU, and the data cache stores the data which is required by the CPU. Now let us see the second level of cache. So this cache is known as either level 2 cache or a L2 cache. Now this level 2 cache could be either inside the CPU or it could be outside the CPU. Now this level 2 cache could be separate for all the cores or it could be shared between all the cores of the CPU. So if this level 2 cache is outside the CPU, then it is connected with a very high speed bus with the CPU. So the memory size of this level 2 cache is in the range of 256 kilobytes up to the 512 kilobytes. But in terms of the speed, they are slower than the L1 cache. Now the third kind of cache is known as a level 3 cache. So all the processors do not have this level 3 cache, but some higher end processors have this level 3 cache. And this level 3 cache is used to enhance the performance of this level 1 and level 2 caches. Now this level 3 cache is shared among all the cores and it is outside the CPU. The memory size of this level 3 cache is in the range of 1 megabytes up to the 8 megabytes for a high-end processors. But it is slower than the L1 and L2 cache. But still, it is faster than the random access memory or a RAM. So now let us see the process flow when CPU needs some data. So whenever CPU needs some data, then first of all, it will look inside the L1 cache. So if it will not find inside the L1 cache, then it will look inside the L2 cache. And if the data is not inside the L2 cache, then it will look into the L3 cache. So if the CPU finds the data inside the cache memory, then it is known as a cache hit. But if data is not available inside the cache, then it is known as a cache miss. So suppose if data is not available inside the L3 cache, then the CPU will look inside the random access memory or a RAM. And still, if doesn't find any data inside the RAM, then it will get the data from the hard disk drive. So when you are starting your computer for the first time or you are opening some application for the first time, then that data will not be available in either cache memory or in the RAM. So at that time, the CPU will get the data from the hard disk drive. But once the application is opened and then after, if it requires some data, then CPU will get the data either from RAM or through the cache memory. Now you may ask that if this cache memory is so fast, then why the size of this cache memory is only in the megabytes? So the reason is that this cache memory is much costlier than the other memories, and that is the reason you will find only a few megabytes of cache memory inside a CPU. So whenever you are buying some desktop or a laptop for yourself, don't only look the random access memory but also look the how much cache memory that CPU has, because this cache memory decides the overall performance of the processor. And the same thing is applicable for the smartphone processor as well. So I hope in this video you understood what is a cache memory and what is the significance of cache memory inside the computers. So if you have any question or suggestion, please let me know in the comment section below. If you like this video, hit the like button and subscribe to the channel for more such videos.